Pan in Greek mythology was the god of shepherds and hunters, meadows and forests, and of the mountain wilds. He was also considered to be the god of theatrical criticism. His name comes from the ancient Greek word bain, meaning to pasture. He was depicted as a man with horns, legs, and tail of a goat, thick beard, snub nose, and pointed ears. One of the most famous myths about Pan is of how his famous flute came to be. There was once a beautiful wood nymph named Syrinx, daughter of the river god Landon. Pan saw her as she was returning from the hunt one day and was instantly infatuated. She ran in flight, frightened, and he took chase after her until she finally reached where her sisters were, who upon seeing their sister's predicament, promptly turned her into a reed to protect her from Pan. Pan, still infatuated, was mesmerized by the captivating melody the wind blowing through the reeds produced. Unable to distinguish which reed was hers, he cut seven of them, joined them side by side in gradually decreasing lengths, and formed his famous Pan pipe, named Syrinx, after his beloved. He was henceforth seldom seen without it. Pan's affinity for nymphs is also responsible for the phenomenon of the echo. Echo, in Greek mythology, was a magical wood nymph who had the most beautiful voice, was incredibly musical, and owned a very loving heart. Echo had previously been cursed by Hera for helping Zeus hide his affairs from her. Discovering her betrayal, Hera cursed Echo by taking away her ability to speak and leaving her with only the ability to repeat the most recently spoken words of another person. Echo had previously fallen in love with Narcissus, and having had that foiled, she determined to stay alone and rejected all suitors. Out in the woods one day, Pan spotted Echo and fell madly in love with her. Echo, ever true to herself, refused to have anything to do with him. Pan was so angered by her rejection that he used his powers to panic his shepherds. The panic was so intense that the shepherds went mad and proceeded to tear Echo to pieces. She was then carried by the wind to the ends of the earth. Now Gaia, the Earth Mother, had a soft spot for Echo, and though she could not change what had been done, she ensured that the pieces of Echo that were left were able to keep whatever voice remained to them. This is why you will sometimes hear a piece of echo repeating your words when out in the beauty of nature.